So it's been a very frustrating night. You know, as if you watched the prior episode, you probably already knew that I accidentally deleted an entire episode. So, you know, besides that mistake, it turns out I also deleted footage for this display. So I'm not sure what's going on. You know, probably I'm lacking sleep, so I'm going to sleep soon after finishing filming this display. So just a quick description of this display. Here I have Black Mask playing cards with a bunch of rogues. So they are not pictured here, so it's up to your imagination. So this is something that I suddenly had inspiration to do. So I have him flanked by Mr. Freeze and Deathstroke. So, you know, the Black Mask figure, in case you're not already aware, is a pain in the ass to pose. So I managed to make this figure work for this display. So basically, that's the essence of ACBA. So, yeah, you know, let's see what ideas crop up in my mind, pop up in my mind over the next few weeks or so. So stay tuned for more Mato. Comment, subscribe to this channel. So I look forward to hearing from you guys. Let me tell you guys, you know, ACBA is really about all the minor details, even the head angles. A few millimeters makes a difference. So I've been mucking around with this display for the past half an hour or so. So this is my final display. So I have all the figures kind of looking in here, this angle. So yeah, I think this works pretty well. So all these figures are not new. Only the Punisher is new. So this is the variant, the Marvel Now Thunderbolts variant. Everything else is figures I've had before. So I'm just gonna continue to tweak this display a bit more before I'm satisfied, and then I'll post the pictures. So I have more figures to review. Nothing much to say about this Punisher. It's the same version that we got previously, just that it's a repaint. I normally don't buy repaints, but I just thought that this Marvel Now Thunderbolts team is quite cool. So they have yet to release the Agent Venom. So I just have the Icons Venom as a replacement for the Agent Venom, which I think it works quite well. So I'll be reviewing more figures in a bit and doing more displays, so stay tuned. So I'll quickly talk about the rest of the package. So that's the Jean Grey, the Marvel Now Scarlet Spidey, Rocket Raccoon, and the Wrecker Crew figure. So I think out of the whole bunch, I mean, of course I was obviously looking forward to the Punisher, but I think the other one, surprisingly, I was looking forward to was the Wrecker figure. I have one more from this wave, which is the Black Panther, but it's currently with Flash Thompson, aka Michael Archuleta, for a custom job. So yeah, I'm gonna do a display with the Wrecker figure. The rest, not so excited. If you do wanna get a Jean Grey, you can ping me. As for the Scarlet Spidey, I like the color scheme. You know, I told myself I've had enough of Spider-Man figures, but at the end of the day, I still caved in and got another one. Rocket Raccoon was because I bought a bunch of figures that came with the Bath pieces, so I might as well have completed it. So, same deal, if you want the Rocket Raccoon, ping me and we'll strike a deal. Oh, I actually forgot one figure, which was the Modern Hawkeye. To be frank, I was actually wanting the Dark Avengers variant of the Hawkeye. But then here, I'm kind of stuck with the modern Hawkman. Why do I keep saying Hawkman? The modern Hawkeye. You know, I get that they probably want to have him look more like Jeremy Renner in the movie, but I'm not too crazy about this look. I think this is the Ultimates look. So I'm not really into the Ultimates. So, you know, I don't know. I mean, his props are quite dope, but I'm kind of sitting on the fence whether I want to keep him or not. So I haven't yet made a decision yet. But we'll see how it goes. Okay, I have to admit, you know, I kind of borrowed this idea from Book Nice. So he did one display previously with Marvel Girl and Professor Xavier. So this is my version of the telekinesis scene. So here Jean Grey, a more mature Jean Grey, is using her telekinesis power to levitate wine out of the goblet, with Professor X observing her. So I think you guys probably know, you know, I'm not really crazy about the X-Men characters. So I kind of worked out a deal with my buddy Victor. So we are doing a trade for this figure. So I don't know, you know, after doing this picture, I may change my mind after all. I don't know, let's see how it goes. But a pretty decent figure. Very heavy head sculpt because of the hair. Not easy to balance her, but I made it work. So yeah, I think the picture came out quite well. Okay, today was a very fruitful day, so I've gotten another half of the Xavier's School for Gifted Youngsters Gate. So basically, it's also known as the X-Mansion Gate. I have a bunch of modded figures from Flash Thompson, aka Michael Archuleta. And then I got a bunch of figs from Hugo Arias, a good buddy of mine. So what I have here is, he sent me Duke, he sent me a Joker, Thug, and the S-Bats figure. So I'm looking at this guy and it's like, wow, I mean, my gosh, the details on this guy is incredibly detailed. Just realized that the flaps on his legs are very soft, a soft plastic, but then other than that, it's a very solid figure and very detailed. So I'm definitely looking forward to do a display of with that figure. And then I have a whole bunch of other stuff, so it's crazy. My cabinet is getting very messy, and there's a very long backlog of figures that I haven't done displays of. So I gotta get grinding. So I'm gonna do some quick displays, so stay tuned. So I finally have a complete X-Mansion gate. So it's actually both the same side, but it works nonetheless. So here I just have a custom figure with the bent hand figure, Xavier and Jean Grey. So here Jean and Xavier are welcoming a new student. So the girl is probably a guardian, the boy's sister or mother. So I leave it up to your interpretation. So I have them at the gate welcoming the new student. So yeah, nothing fancy, but quite dope, you know. It's quite nice to have a complete gate instead of half a gate. It looks more authentic. So yeah, I'm going to take a few pictures from different angles and see which one works best. Okay, so bunch of new fix. So you know, I featured the X-Force team a few times, but this is the first time I have Duke, and this is the first time I have Sunfire. So I added them together in this display with the X-Force. So Duke, you know, is the videographer of the X-Force team. So here I have him with a video camera and a microphone. So he's joining them on a mission together with Sunfire. So I think this is quite a dope display. So well, nothing much I can say about this display other than the Sunfire figure is pretty dope. You know, I got him for less than 20 US. The same with Duke. So you know, just working on my poses. So vanilla poses, but you know, you have to have some variety, not just a bunch of guys standing around. So I think I did a pretty good job. So I quite like the pictures. Just a little display that I dreamt up. So finally I get a chance to show off the S-Bats. Very detailed figure. So I just here have the S-Bats figure character sneaking up on a bunch of just one clown thug. So I have him being attacked from behind out of the shadows, and the Joker is surprised by the sudden attack. So the two of them are kind of having their way with a woman before the S-Bats interrupts them. So yeah, I think this picture will come out pretty well, so check it out. I'm going to do a few more displays before I call it a night. It's almost the end of Team Week. So I thought I'll do a quick fun display. So here I have some members of the X-Force. So I have Domino, Deadpool. They are kind of doing some preparation. So Domino is on the laptop talking to probably Cyclops or Wolverine. And Doob is going about his business. So in case you guys are not aware, Doob is actually the unofficial videographer of the group. So here he has a microphone and a camera. And then kind of have a dog following him around. So yeah, just a very simple display, but I think it's quite entertaining, something different. So let's see how the pictures turn out. Okay, what I'm doing here is I'm mixing and matching a bunch of Angel and Buffy props. So here I have Nightcrawler in front of an altar, holding a cross in his hands, and you know, the cutout says it all. So I just pose him kneeling. And I think the pictures came out quite well, pretty dope. I've been wanting to do a display like this for quite a while. So in case you guys aren't aware, I'm Christian, so I think it's pretty dope to do a Christian inspired display. So yeah, pretty much had this figure for quite a while, but I think this props work very well with the figure. Finally, I have a chance to use my artificial grass. So here I'm using the rest of the Angel Buffy props as well as the Daredevil cross. So I'm using it with the Minimates Daredevil. So he's kind of in agony. And yeah, pretty much this kind of like a graveyard scene. So probably he's mourning after one of his lovers. So I leave it up to your imagination. Big shout out to my buddy Victor. So what happened was I traded the Jean Grey, the Wolverine Wave. Rocket Raccoon Wave Jean Grey for the Power Driver figure. So I have him here with Wrecker, Madam Mask, and a custom hood. So here they are taking their turns to beat up Daredevil. So just a very cool display that I thought of. You know, you often see pictures of Bullseye or Spider-Man being surrounded by their nemesis. So here I have Daredevil taking a beating as an alternative. So I thought it's pretty dope, you know. I have a bunch of Wrecking Crew figures, and Hood is their boss, with Madam Mask, his right-hand woman. So I thought it would be a very apt display to put together. So I'm really digging the Wrecking Crew figures. Big, nice, bulky, nice detail on them. Colorful as well. So I'm really enjoying the figures. So I'm pretty sure that the pictures will come out very well. I was in two minds to actually get the Star Wars Pit Droids, but after talking to Mindless, actually texting him, he convinced me to get the droids, and I did after all. So definitely no regrets. The droids are very fun, pretty decently articulated. So here I just did a simple display with Mr. Fantastic. So he's kind of working on the droids. One is being worked on, the other one in the backdrop. So I think it works pretty well. So I'm very happy with the pictures. So yeah, I'm going to post them up in a bit. So very dope, you know, if you ever have a chance to come across these droids, get them. You know, I got them for less than 20 US dollars. Yeah, so I think it's pretty bang on buck value for money. Yo guys, so I just got back from CSC, went down to CSC with Mindless and Victor. So I got a bunch of stuff. So here I have the NECA Turtles, the complete set. I believe they are knockoffs. Got this figure as well. I can't remember the name of this figure for the life of me. This guy, ridiculous, local currency $1, which is like less than a dollar US. For this figure, so quite good, you know, it's kind of like a cheerleader character. And then I got the Little Nicky figure, so it's quite dope, you know. I mean, I didn't get the figure, I mean the set for the Little Nicky figure, but for the props. So there's the bulldog in a peeing pose, there's the backdrop, radiator. So pretty dope, nice stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna take a shower and then get down to playing with these guys soon. So stay tuned for more Mato. Hey guys, so my backlog just got bigger. So I think previously I showed you the mountain of figures I have. Some I haven't displayed yet. But then today, you know, having gone to CSC, I have more stuff. So I have the NECA Turtles, but I believe that these are the knockoffs. So anyways, I'm going to do a quick display with them. So give me a moment to set it up, and I hope you guys look forward to seeing the display. Okay, I have the display set up. So I have the NECA Turtles kind of surrounding the Little Nicky dog figure. So the dog figure is about to pee. So yeah, I just want to do a funny shot where the turtles are sneaking up on the dog because they're angry that the dog is about to pee. So yeah, I think the picture kind of works. So I'm quite happy with the picture. So I'm gonna post the picture up in a moment's time. Okay, I had this panther for a while, Black Panther. So what's happened is that Flash Thompson, aka Michael Archuleta, did a mod for me. So this is the John Stewart head. So it's swappable between the Black Panther figure and the Green Lantern John Stewart figure. So here I just have him in front of the throne. I remove the banners that were originally on the prop, and then I just placed it on the artificial grass patch that I have. And then just a simple display, I have him kind of going to mask himself in a relaxed pose. So I quite like how the pictures turn out, so check them out. So here is a simple Constantine display that I've done. So I was kind of in two minds, you know, between doing a Constantine or Thunderbolts display. But then Mindless convinced me to do this display. And, you know, of course, there have been a bunch of Thunderbolts pictures done on the ACBA group quite frequently recently. So I guess this is the better option. So here I just have a custom female fig cowering behind Constantine. So he's kind of warding off some demonic forces using a cross and a book, maybe a book of spells. So yeah, this is gonna be a last Mato episode for quite a while, because I'll be away on my national duty as a reserve, army reserve. So this is my last opportunity to serve my nation, and after that I'm done for good, I'll be retired. So I have a bunch of backlog, as I mentioned previously. Not to mention, you know, I haven't opened a Min on card Yotsuba. I haven't assembled my Danbot kit model. So yeah, you know, I've been trying to get grinding recently, been coming out with a lot of pictures, but I have a lot of other figures that I have yet to touch. So I guess I have to get down to doing displays with those figures after I finish my national commitment. So this has been Mato. Stay tuned for more Mato in the future. I'll be away for quite a while. I'm not sure when the next Mato will be. It could be 3 weeks time, a month's time. So enjoy this episode. Subscribe, comment, and like. So Major Awesome signing off. Have a good weekend. Take care. Ciao.
Crispy.
So I have this tiny clip at the end of the so-called my version of the end of credits video. So this is something I copied from DC and Marvel movies. So usually at the end of the credits there's a Easter egg video. So this is my version. So this is the Little Nicky backdrop. So as you can see, I have a standard DCUC figure, and the backdrop is a bit too short. So, but nonetheless, it's kind of dope. So what I've done is I've taken the Atom figure, the mini Atom figure, propped up the backdrop on some cartons, some crates. And then I have the Joker thug for scale. So in the backdrop you have the radiator, and yeah, so just something simple, just a simple display. I thought I wanted to do something with scale in mind. So I guess this would be my money shot. So yeah, just something fun to make use of the prop. So I won't be posting for a while. So be patient, guys. I'll be back grinding after my national service commitment is over. So take care.